Hey family, this is Pastor Jennifer, lead pastor of Jackson Revival Center Church. This is day 19 of our 21-day journey of prayer and fasting. Listen, I'm getting more and more excited as the days pass. I just am so excited to see what God is going to do. As I look back on our consecration back in August, I'm thinking of businesses that are birthed. I'm thinking of relationships that were restored. I'm thinking of prayers that were answered, of people who are getting ready to move into homes, people who have received promotions on their job because of the prayers and the petitions that were laid out before the Lord then in prayer. So those of you who are praying right now, you may feel like nothing is happening. You may feel like you're just walking around hungry. Listen, I want to make sure that you are taking time to get before the Lord in prayer, that you are renewing your mind to the promises of God, and that you are waiting in expectation to see what God is going to do on your behalf. Our prayer focus today, we're praying that God would bless us to be a blessing to others. The Bible tells us that the man that soweth sparingly will also reap sparingly, but the one who sows bountifully shall also reap bountifully, that every man should give according as he has purposed it in his heart. Don't give grudgingly or out of necessity, because God loves a cheerful giver, and God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you, yes, you, always having all sufficiency in all things, may abound to every good work. So listen, I want to pray today. I'm going to join my faith with yours that God would bless us, but it's not just for us to stack up blessings on our own behalf, but God is blessing you and I so that we can be a blessing to others. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you today, and Father, we thank you that more and more you are giving us your nature. You are giving us your character, and we know part of your nature is to give. It is your character to give, that you loved us so much, you gave your only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. Father, you put your spirit in us, which means we should have your nature, your character. So, Father, we're asking today that you would bless us, that we may be a blessing to other people. We ask that you would help us to be sensitive to the needs of those who are going without. Father, let us be sensitive to the person behind us in the restaurant making an order. Let us be sensitive to somebody at the gas station who's using their last $5 to get gas, to get to church, or to get to work. Father, let us be sensitive to the needs of those around us, whether we know them or not. Let us perceive when there's a need, and Father, when it's there, let us be supplied to meet that need. We thank you right now that you're giving us the mindset of a giver, that you're giving us the heart of a giver. And Father, we ask that for every need, you would make us the supply, because you're our supply. We thank you right now for the blessing to be blessed and to be a blessing to others. We give you the praise, the glory, and the honor. In Jesus' name, everybody said amen, amen, and amen. Y'all go make the rest of today a great day. I'll see you tomorrow.